All my global customers have one common problem. Let's say someone is presenting in English in a Teams meeting, but there are many people who don't understand English very well. But they are not going to say that. The issue is, as a presenter, I'm not sure whether I have communicated the topic very well. Fortunately, Teams has two elegant ways to handle this situation. Let's have a look. When you start presenting, click on the More button, Language and Speech, and turn on Live Caption. You are the presenter. You don't need to see what you are speaking. So why did we come here? Because there is a wheel here. So open the caption settings and choose the spoken language. Even though, for example, I'm speaking English, I have an Indian accent. So this will increase the quality of transcription. Once you have set the language, you can switch it off. Now let's see what happens on the other side. Now you are speaking in English, but the participants understand a different language. What should they do? Again, as a participant, click on More button. Yes, go to Language Speech, turn on Live Captions. And then, very important, by default, it is going to show the same language. It's just converting audio to text. But I want it in my language. So this is something most probably nobody in your audience is going to know. So you have to tell everyone proactively that they can change the transcription language individually. Ask them to click on the sprocket or the wheel. And here they have to change the caption language. So I'm going to change it to Hindi. The speaker is continuing to speak in English, but it is getting transcribed and translated live. Now, remember, this is one of the attendees. There could be 50 different attendees, and each one of them could have chosen any of these languages. Now, the only problem is, for this to work, the person who organized the meeting needs a Teams Premium license. People who are attending the meeting don't need Teams Premium license. Apart from changing the caption language, so this pane allows you to customize. You can change the height of the pane. Either it should be shown at the bottom or top, and the font size. And of course, the font background and font color. Now let's look at another equally effective way of improving communication in a multilingual meeting. I'm going to click on Share, but I'm not going to share a presentation by going to Screen or Window. Down below, you will see PowerPoint Live. And here, I can choose a presentation. This presentation is going to be uploaded to Microsoft Server, and it's going to run from there. But of course, as a presenter, you are the one presenting it, so nothing is lost. I'm seeing the slide, I'm seeing my notes, and I'm also seeing a slide sorter kind of view. So I can jump to any slide anytime. Audience can see the current slide only. They don't have any clue about my other slides, nor can they see my notes. So best of both worlds. Right now, audience member can change my slides. So in order to prevent that from happening, as soon as you start sharing as PowerPoint Live, immediately disable this private view. And now attendees will only be able to see what you are showing. They can't change slides on their own. While we are doing that, this is in English and I don't understand English very well. So as a user, as an attendee, click on these three dots, go to Translate Slides and choose the language you want. So each person in the audience could have chosen a different language. Presenter is still presenting in English and everyone benefits. Only caveat is most people don't know about it. So in the beginning of the meeting, make sure all attendees have enabled live captions and chosen the correct caption language and set the captions properly. And second, when you start presenting, make sure everyone in the audience knows that below that three dots, there's an amazing translate feature. So let me know if you like it. And also let me know what are the other problems you face while working in meetings, in collaboration, in task management, and I'll be happy to create videos for you. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.